بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولادي وبناتي. Today إن شاء الله we will present lecture number 10 and it will be concentrate on managing economics of scale in a supply chain part 2 to present safety stock and reorder point. Before starting the new part today, part 2, I needed to inform you something here, which is a number of slides which is not clear in the part 1 presented at the last lecture. So I will present it first without explanation because it's explained before, like this. Rule of cycle inventory in a supply chain, and the second page, verify the inventory shrinkage, my sons and daughters. Also this type of page, inventory investment measures, it's explained in the part 1, but it's not completed as a data, so I will complete this now by presenting it. This page, which refers to inventory turnover calculation, weeks of supply, the complete part for the previous example in the previous page, you will find that yes, how to calculate the days of supply and how to make sure from the number of days of supply is like you are calculating by using the equations. Okay, bar 2 starts from this page to present the discount model or quantity discount model, and this model is similar to the model presented in the first part, which is economic order quantity or EOQ model. It's similar with it in case of using the equations to calculate this total cost. Total cost here by using this type of equation, but now by using the quantity discount model, we will be adding like here, which is CD or the cost of order discounts. Okay? The unit price here for this type of model is based on the quantity orders. So this is will be more explained and more having more details when presenting the example. So please don't forget, we will use the same equation like we presented in the EOQ model here, like it, yes. And the exception here is, yes. For this part which having the plus CD. Okay, what's in the next type? The next page here is identify the procedures used to calculate the quantity discount model. You will find that in the first you have to start with the calculate the EOQ or the quantity orders at the lowest price first, okay, and then like here you will determine the, in case of this type of EOQ according to the lowest price, it's like it's matching with the quantity presented from the suppliers or not, and then in case of yes you can stop, in case of no you can complete and continue the remaining steps like here. So you will start to find is there any visibility of the EOQ at the next higher price. Okay, So please don't forget, we are starting with the lowest price first, and then in case of it's not visible, or this price is this type of quantity which you are calculating at the lowest price is matching with the quantity presenting or offered from the suppliers or not. And then in case of yes, you can stop. In case of no, you have to continue the remaining steps. This type of steps will be more clarified in case of presenting the example to understand all the steps needed to solve this model. Quantity discount model. This model, according to this type of example, refers to Collins Sport Store searches for a different hat supplier. Okay. According to this type of paragraph, you will find that I'm writing the present supplier, and in the same paragraph, yes, new supplier, which are written with different colors, to differentiate between what's offers from the present supplier and what the new supplier can offer as a new option. Okay, so in the first part you will find that yes, the present supplier here charges $10 each and requires minimum quantities of 490 hats. This present supplier identify the price per hat is $10, and the minimum quantity can be purchased is 490 hats. In case of you understand that the annual demand is 12,000 hats, okay, inside this sports store, okay, and the ordering cost is $20, and the inventory carrying cost is 20% of the hat. It's not direct, okay, and a new supplier, yes. And the new supplier offers hats at $9 per unit, okay? The previous one or the present can present $10 per unit. And now the new supplier, according to the search of other suppliers, this type of sports store find another supplier can offer a lower price per hat, which is equal $9. In lots, this means that there is condition in lots of 4,000. This means in case of this sports store needed to buy this type of hats with $9 per unit, the quantity orders should be 4,000. Okay, according to this data given, who should he buy from? Okay, according to this data, we will take a certain steps to solve this problem and to answer about this question. The first, like we mentioned in the previous page, we have to calculate the EOQ, or the economic ordered quantity. It starts with the lowest price. Here there is $10 price for the present supplier, and the second suppliers can offer $9. So we will present with the lowest price by calculating this type of equation, starts with $9. And after calculating, we need to understand, is it visible or not? First, the EOQ model at $9 per unit equal, yes. What about the equations? The equation is 2DS. What, like the previous page, 2DS, 2 is a constant, D is the annual demand here, which is equal 12,000, and 20 here refers to the ordering cost, okay? All of them over the H, or the carrying cost. The carrying cost of inventory is 20% of the hat. 20% of the hat, it means that, yes, the hat price is $9 times 20%. This means that it will be equal $1.80 per unit. Okay. All this data will be the root of, please don't forget, the root of all this data given now, and then all of them will be equal 560 0.397 hertz, which is equal as the approximation 516 hertz. Okay, now we need to understand the EOQ or the economic order quantity equal 516 hertz, but this type of quantity, it's visible, okay, it's suitable or not. Okay, we will find that according to this arrow here. Yes, since the EOQ of 516 is not visible, so why? Because this supplier or new supplier, he presents $9 per unit, but at the same time put a certain conditions, which is buying lots of 4,000. So 516 or 516 is lower than the 4,000. So it's this type of price, it's not visible because he should buy lots, should buy. Okay, so calculate the total cost for each price to make the decision. Here we needed to return back to calculate the cost as the cost, total cost in case of the $10 per unit, or the total cost of inventory in case of the price is $9. Okay, okay, I will start with the cost of $10. Yes, what about the equations? The equations here is like we are presenting now. Yes, the first one here is the D over Q. Okay, as $10. The present supplier, which can present $10, he the minimum quantities or the quantity is 490, so I will use it. 12,000 over Q, or D over Q. D is 12,000 over the Q, 490, times the cost of ordering, which is $20, plus, what about this? Yes, the same, 490, Q over 2, okay, times here, the, here you will find that times the, the H, or the cost of holding inventory, which refers to 20% of the price per hat. So because here the price is $10, so 20% times $10, it will be $2. Okay, plus D, the annual demand, times the price given here. Okay, or the cost per unit, 12,000 times 10. According to all the summation for all this type of data, it will be equal $1,020.98. Okay, so this is in case of the cost or the total cost for buying the this type of units or hats at the price of 10. In case of we needed to buy this type of lots with $9. $9 refers to that you should buy lots with 4,000 units. So the equations will be differ. Yes, D over Q. The D here is the annual demand, like the previous, but Q here is the lot size, which is 4,000 according to the conditions required from the new supplier. Okay, the same $20 as ordering cost plus. Okay, here the Q, 4,000 over 2 times 1.8, because here you will find that 20%, like we mentioned before, 20% times 9 will be equal 1.8 as holding cost per unit, plus here the D times C. The D here is the annual demand, and the C here is our cost per unit, which is $9. Okay, so the total cost will be $101.660. Okay, now to choose or to take decision about which one of this type of supplier is better, so we have to find, what about the saving here? The saving, is there any savings cost or not? In case of buying the total cost, in case of buying this type of hats with $10, the cost will be 120.980. And in case of buying the total, buying the lots with 4,000, and at the price per head is $9, so the cost here is lower. So the difference between the cost of $10, 120 like here, 980 minus the cost, total cost of buying these hats per hat with $9, okay, 101.660. So the sales cost will be 19.320. This means that in case of buying this type of lots, 4,000 units, at the price of $9, can achieve saving cost with 19.320. So it's better to buy the lot for 4,000 and dealing with the new supplier. Okay. Another type of example, which refers to how to determine the optimal order quantity and calculating the total annual cost by using different type of data. You will find that the example given here is Surge Electric uses 4,000 toggle switches a year. Switches are priced as follows. You will find that different type of options available. In case of buying from 1 to 499, so the price will be 90 cents per one. In case of buying 500 to 999, so the price will be 85 cents per unit. In case of buying 1,000 or more, so the price will be 80 cents per unit. Okay. This type of data is given from the suppliers, and it costs approximately $30 to prepare an order. So the cost of ordering is $30 for making this order and receiving it. And the carrying cost is 40% of purchasing price per unit on an annual basis. Okay, this is all the data given here. And the questions needed to answer it is the first, determine the optimal order quantity, and the second, calculate the total annual cost. The solution for this problem starts with to find the minimum point for each price, and then locate a visible minimum point. Okay. According to this type of data, you will find that the annual demand, or the demand rate, is 4,000 switches per year, and the cost of ordering and receiving this order is $30. Okay. And the holding cost is equal 0.4 per unit from the price per unit. Do you understand? Okay. So, before starting to solve the problem, you have to calculate first the holding cost per unit. We will describe this data in this in the following table. Yes, the first column refers to the range of the units, okay, and the second the price per unit for each range, and the third calculating the holding cost per unit as a percent of the price per unit. For the first range, the 0.80 as price per unit times 0.4 will be equal to 0.36, and the second price per unit 0.85 for the second range. 0.4 times 0.85 equal 0.34 as the cost of holding per unit, and the third range the price per unit is 0.80, times 0.4, so the cost will be 0.32 as all cost per unit. So this is will be prepared before starting to take the actions to solve the problem. Okay. The first step to solve this problem is to find the minimum point for each price. By using the equation which equal the root of 2ds over h. Okay. Now I will start to calculate the minimum point for each price. The minimum point here refers to the amount of units can be purchased, okay, for each price will be given, okay. Now we will start with trying to calculate the minimum point of using the minimum price. Please take care, the condition here is start with the minimum or the least the lowest price, which here according to the data given is 0.80 per unit. Okay, so like here the minimum point or the quantity needed to purchase at the price of 0.80, by using the root of 2ds over h, you will find that 2 is constant, the d here the demands according to the data described in the previous page is 4,000 units times the 30, which refers to the cost of ordering and receiving it, over the h at the level of 0.80 price is equal 0.32, okay, as a holding cost per unit. The results will be 866 switches or 866 units. Okay, okay, this is the minimum number of units can be purchased at the price of 0.80, but we needed here to understand 866 is not lying at the as a range of units, is not lying at the range of the price of 0.80, but it's lying in the range between 500 and 999, and the cost per or the price per unit here is 0.85, not 0.80. So this type of size is not visible. Do you understand the meaning? Because the units as the minimum units inside the this price of the least price 0.80 is not matching with the range of this of this level of the price, so it's the results of the 866 is not visible for the price of 0.80. Now we will find the next trail. Okay, try of using the next price. The lowest price was 0.80. The next price is 0.80 or the above price above 0.80 is 0.85 according to the data in the previous page, and we will use the same equation, the root of 2ds over h, yes, the similar to 4030, but h here is different over 0.34 as the holding cost per unit in case the price was 0.85. The results found is the minimum number of units can be purchased is 840 switches, and here you will find that this 840 is lying between the range of 500 and 999, and already is matching matching with this range and matching with the level of the price here, which is equal 0.85. So we will say that this this minimum points is visible minimum points, okay, because the price 0.85 is matching with the units calculated, which is 840 at the level of the range line between 500 and 999 units. Now, you will find that the next step is after the first, then you can compute the total cost for 840, okay, because it's visible. So we need to understand what about the total cost for this type of quantity. And after calculating, compare it to the total cost of the minimum quantity necessary to obtain a price of 0.80 per switch. Now, we have to understand, because the quantity of 840 became as visible, it means that this 840 is lying between 500 and 999, and it's matching with the price of the 0.85, okay? Now it's visible. And then we will compare between the total cost of this quantity, 840, and the total cost at the lower price in the first. The lower price here is the 0.80. And compare between each of them to find which one of them is the better decision. To calculate the total cost here, we will use this type of equation, which refers to the carrying cost plus the ordering cost plus the purchasing discount, purchasing quantity, okay? What about the details for the carrying cost? Carrying cost here is the quantity over 2 times H, okay, holding cost, plus the ordering cost here. The ordering cost here will be calculating by divide the D, the demand, over Q, okay? The Q here is refers to the quantity needed to buy times S. S here is the cost of ordering, plus purchasing discount. Purchasing discount here is the price per unit times the demand required. Okay, and now we will present the details related. The first one, which is, yes, we needed to understand what about the total cost for 840 as the visible unit. Okay, and at the same time, we need to calculate the total cost at the price, at the smallest price or the lowest price, which is 0.80. The quantity here as 0.80 price per unit is starts with 1,000 units and more. Okay, so you can understand the total cost for the visible units, 840, and you have to calculate the total cost for the lowest price, 0.80, which is equal starts with 1,000 and more. The total cost for 840 equal, yes, the quantity here is 840 over 2, okay, and the holding cost per unit for this visible units is 0.34, which is lying between 500 and 999. You will find that the cost of holding cost per unit is equal 0.34 from the third column in the previous table, plus the demand rates here is 4,000 over Q. The Q here, yes, 840 times 30, and 30 here is the cost of ordering, yes, plus B of purchasing discount. A purchasing discount here, you will find that times between the price per unit, yes, 0.85, and the demand required needed is 4,000. So after the summation for all this type of data, it will be equal $3,686. In other side, we will calculate the total cost at the third range, according because it refers to the lowest price of 0.80, yes, which is equal. The quantity here is 1000 over 2 times the holding cost for this type of range is 0.32 plus the demand required is 4000 over Q here in this time is 1000, okay, times 30, which is equal the ordering cost plus the price per unit here in this range is 0.80, the lowest price, times the demand required 4000, so the total cost will be 3480. The comparison between each of them will find that the lowest cost will be, or the minimum cost ordering size is buying 1000 units. Okay, previous example provide data for calculating the total cost of the discount model, and here yes there is another type of data which refers to different type of options presented from the suppliers, and here use another type of data for calculating this type of information, the total cost, and you can start with the lowest price and then the next one to find where is the visible points, and we understand well now what we mean by the visible units. The visible units refers to that the units after calculating the EOQ or the roots of 2GS over H, the quantity after calculating is inside the range of the price given in this type of range. Okay. The current page is the safety stock. Safety stock here because the company knowing that this safety stock refers to that there is cost of holding it, so a manager should balance between the cost of carrying cost, the cost of carrying safety stock units, and the risk of reducing the stock out. This is very important because they don't need it to say the units required from the customers is not available, so they needed to improve the customer service level. So improving the customer service level refers to decrease the risk of stock out, and this means that the company will keep safety stock units. Okay, and this is refers to that the order cycle or the service level. The service level refers to here the probability that demand will not exceed the supply during the time, and this probability refers to 95% or as a confidence level that this demand from the customers will not exceed the supply during the time. Okay, and take care, so the risk of stock out is against the service level of the complement of the service level, and you will find that here there's two factors refers to how the company can define the amount of safety stock. These two factors are the average demand rate, and the average lead time. And the second factor is the desired service level. The safety stock means yes, maybe like we presented in the previous page, the company needed to maintain a certain units to serve the customer and to match with the customer service level. Okay. Another concept needed here to present is the ROP or the reorder point. Take care. The reorder point here, as the notes presented in the first page, the reorder level depends on whether a safety stock is maintained or not. So there's a link between the reorder point and the safety stock. I will present inside this page and the next the cases in case of there is safety stock, or maybe the company has no safety stock. The first case here is assume that this company has no safety stock. So the reorder level can be worked out using the following formula, which is the reorder level equal the average demand times the lead time. Take care, the average demand times the lead time. Okay, and both of the demand and the lead time must be in the same unit of time. It means in case of the average demand measured with weeks, so the lead time should be also measured with weeks. Okay, the second case is in case of this company maintains or keeps a safety stock. So the reorder level will be calculated using the next equation refers to here. Yeah, the average demand times the lead time plus the safety stock. Do you understand the difference between the case number one and the case two? Case one and case two. Yes, the part of this equation is the same, average demand times the lead time. But the first case, because there is no stock, safety stock, so there is no data in the equation about this safety stock. But because in the second case, the company maintains already a safety stock, so I will add with the same equation plus safety stock. And we can present a certain example to identify and to clarify how we can calculating and using this equation. Example, ABC company has decided to hold a safety stock. Do you understand? Decided to hold a safety stock. Okay. Safety stock, the abbreviation will be used SS. Holding a safety stock equivalent to 500 units of daily usage for 5 days. Do you understand? And the 7 days of lead time. Calculate the reorder level safety stock in this case. Okay. First, we have to understand what about the quantity of this the quantity of holding safety stock units. As mentioned here, which is equivalent 500 units daily usage for 5 days. So I will find the times between 500 units of daily usage times 4 days. So the results will be 2,500 units. This is will be the hold safety stock units. To calculate the reorder level for this type of example, it will be, yes, it will be consist two types of that. The first is, yeah, the average demand is 500 units times the lead time here is 7 days. Okay, 7 days, yes, plus the safety stock. Like here, the safety stock is calculating in the first step, which is equal 2,500. Okay, it will be equal plus 2,500 SS units. So the results will be 600 units as the reorder level. Okay, so in case of this company maintains safety stock, okay, according to data, you have to start first to calculate, because this safety stock is not given as a direct number. So calculate the safety stock first, and then after calculating, you have to calculate the reorder level. The reorder level will be the average demand times the lead time plus this quantity of safety stock. Okay. The third case here is the stock out costs are very high. Okay. So maintaining maximum safety stock might make sense. The stock out costs are very high. In case of the company found that the stock out costs are very high. Okay. And maintaining maximum safety stock might make sense, might make problem. So how this company can calculate the maximum safety stock level? Here we are not talking about the safety stock level like first and the second case. No, here we need to understand what about the maximum safety stock level. Okay, the maximum safety stock level here will be calculated used this formula, which is equal maximum weekly demand minus average weekly demand. This is the first, and this subtraction times the maximum lead time, also in weeks. Okay, so the maximum weekly demand minus the average weekly demand, and the results will be times maximum lead time in weeks also. I will present a certain example to provide data and explanation for how using this equation. A certain company here, in case of you work as a management accountant at Merlin Company, which provides consumables used in diesel generators, and your average weekly consumption is 1250 units, and the maximum consumption, the maximum, okay, is 1500. Till now we are providing data about the average weekly consumption 1250, and the maximum consumption, which is 1500. Okay, the lead time, or the average lead time, and the maximum lead time, okay, for the order that you place are 2 weeks and 3 weeks respectively. Okay, further, the stock out cost is $4 per unit, and the carrying cost are $2 per unit per annual, and you place 12 orders per annual. And if you are the most risk averse when it comes to your reputation, so this company may build a safety stock based on worst case condition. Okay, how calculating the reorder level at the maximum safety level? Okay, to calculate it, I will start first with calculating the maximum safety stock, which is equal by using the previous equation, which are written with the blue line here. You will find that the maximum weekly demand, which equal 1500 minus the average weekly demand, which refers to 1250. First, we have to find the subtraction, all of them times the maximum lead time. The maximum lead time here, yes, it's 3. Okay, 3 weeks. So the results will be 750 units. After calculating the maximum safety stock, calculate the reorder level. The reorder point level equal the average weekly demand times the average lead time, then after the multiply the average weekly demand times the average lead time, the results will be adding to the safety stock. Okay, so the average weekly demand is 1250, and the average lead time, according to mentioned in the paragraph, is 2 weeks. Okay, and then plus the safety stock from the first solution step, which is equal 750. The results will be 3,250 units. So the your reorder level at the maximum safety stock level, 750 units, would be 3,250. So this company will kill the maximum stock level, which is equal 750, and in case of it needs to make reorder points or reorder units, take this action at the level of 3,250 units. Okay. Another example for the reorder point. To calculate the reorder point here, you will find another data given, and you will find in the first paragraph a product has a reorder point of 110 units. Okay, this means that the company will start to make new order in case of the units inside the warehouse will be reached to 110 units. Okay, and is ordered 4 times a year. Is ordered 4 times a year. This reorder points is done 4 times a year. The following table shows the historical distribution of demand values observed during the reorder point or the reorder periods of a year. Okay, you will find that the demand maybe starts from 100 units, 110 units, 120 units, 130 units, and the probability for receiving this type of demand 0.3, 0.4, 0.2, 0.1. Okay, and the managers have noted that stock outs occur 30% of the time with this policy, and question whether a change in inventory policy and to include some safety stock, you understand? Okay, might and the keeping or including some safety stock might be an improvement the conditions, and the managers realized that any safety stock would increase the service level, but are worried about the increased cost of carrying the safety stock. Currently, stock outs are valued at $20 per unit per occurrence, while inventory carrying costs are $10 per unit per year. And the requirements here is different. What's your advice to this type of company? And the second question is, do higher levels of safety stock add to total cost or not? And we needed to answer also about the third question, which is, what's the best level of safety stock? The data here is different from the previous example, and the requirement here for this data is different. So I will start to present the solution for this example direct in the next page. The solution here for this problem is written here in this type of page. You will find that it consists of 4 columns. The first column is the action, the second is safety stock cost, the third is the stock out cost, and the last is the total cost. Take care here to take actions or to understand what about the safety stock units needed to keep it. This is will not be based on calculating the cost of safety stock cost only, but the also to identify and calculate the stock out cost. Okay, I will start to explain this problem part by part. The first part here is the ROP, or the reorder point, according to data given in the previous page, at the 110 units. You will find the demand starts from 100, then 110, 120, and 130. Okay, according to this first column, you will find that. Why there is no data about the reorder, the demand in case of it's equal 100? In case of the demand is 100 and the reorder point is at 110 according to the data given in the previous page, so this means that this company already still has enough units to cover or to match the demand at 100 units. Okay, so the solution here will be starts in case of the demand is 110 from the second level of the demand, and the first action refers to that. Here the demand, like the equation written under the first action, the demand is equal 110 and the reorder point is 110, so that subtraction will be equal 0. So the company in this type of level, it doesn't need to keep safety stock. Okay, it will be equal 0 already. It has units to match the requirements of the demand. Okay, so the safety stock will be equal 0. In case of calculating the cost of this safety stock, it will be equal 0 times $10 according to data given. It will be equal $0. Okay, now we needed to calculate the stock out cost for this first action. Okay, the stock out cost, you will find here different type of data needed to calculate it. Okay, the stock out will be appear in the next demand requirement. Okay, not at the level of 110 but at 120 and at 122. Okay, 120 and 130. Okay, there is a component like I'm written, like the data written here, pro, it's a probability, and the second is demand minus the reorder point, and the third is stock out value, which is $20 per unit, and the order 4 times a year. Okay, all this type of data which is written under the stock out cost here, under the calculation here for this type of part, I will explain how using this. The stock out will be appear not at the level of the demand of 110, but it will be appeared in case of the demand increase to be 120 and 130. Okay, first the probability in case of the demand increase to be 120, it will be equal 0.2 times the demand here, it will be 120, and the reorder point is 110, so 120 minus 110 equal 10 times the stock out's value is $20 per unit. Okay, times 4, which refers to order 4 times a year. Okay, so 0.2 times 10 times $20 times 4, it will be equal $160. And in case of the demand increased to be 130, what happened? What about the stock out cost? The probability, like written here, 0.1 given times the demand minus the reorder point, the demand in case of 130 minus the reorder point 110, so it will be equal 20 units, times 20 as stock out cost value, $20 per unit, times four as ordered four times a year. Okay, okay, so 0.1 times 20 times 20 times 4 will be equal 160, and the submission will be $320 as a total cost. Now we will transfer to the second action. The second action here is the demand equal 120. Okay, and the reorder point is 110. So the demand minus 100 minus the reorder point, 120 minus 110, will be 10 units. This means this company needs to keep 10 units as safety stock. Okay, to calculate the cost of this 10 units as safety stock, so 10 units times the inventory carrying cost, like written under the $10. So the results will be $100. Okay, what about the calculation for the stock out cost in this type of condition? Assume that the demand increased more than 120, it will be 130. What about the stock out cost? The stock out cost will be like the previous component pro. Okay, the probability will be 0.1 times. What about here? The demand minus the reorder point. 130 minus 100 minus 120 in case of the demand increased more than 120 became 130. So 130 minus 120, it will be equal 10 units times the stock out value, which is $20, okay, times 20 times 4 as the ordered 4 times a year. Okay, so 0.1 times 10 units times $20 per unit times 4 times ordered per year, it will be equal $80. And then the total cost will be equal the cost of stock out stock safety stock cost 100 plus the cost of stock out cost $80. So the total cost will be $180. What about in the third? The third option here is assume that the demand in the fourth time became as 130. So 130 as a demand minus the reorder point 110. This means that this company should keep the safety stock or SS as 20 units. Okay, what about the cost of this safety stock of 20 units? So 20 units as the curve here presented, 20 times the cost or inventory carrying cost, which is equal $10. So the total cost will be for the safety stock cost will be equal $200. What happened here for the stock out cost? Stock out cost here, there is no. Why? Because already there is safety stock. Okay, and this demand is the last level for the period number 4 for this year. So already there is, listen, already there is 20 units and there is no next order times year. This is the last period of the year, period number 4. So there is no stock out. It will be equal 0. So what's the total cost? The total cost here will be equal the cost of safety stock cost, which is equal to 100 plus 0 as stock out cost. The total cost will be 200. Now we needed to understand. The first one is, what about the lowest cost here? The lowest cost here in the column of the total cost will be equal $180, which refers to, yes, this company, it's better to keep 10 units as safety stock, and the cost for this type of policy will be equal $180. But next point should be focused on it. What about it? take care about the relationship between the safety stock cost and the stock out cost. In the first option, 110 as demand, the safety stock cost is zero, but the stock out cost is 320. And in the second option, in case of the demand is equal 120, you will find that the safety stock cost became 100, increased, and the stock out cost decreased to be as 80. Okay. What happened in the third option? The third option, in case of the demand, became 130. What happened here? The number of units of the safety stock increased to be as 20 units, and the cost will be 200. This means that the cost of the safety stock increased from 0 to be 100 to be 200, although the stock out cost decreased from 320 80 to be 0. This means the managers should not be concerned about the carrying cost only, shouldn't be concerned about the carrying cost only. Take the decision about the carrying cost, but here we should consider that while carrying cost rise, okay, the stock out cost fall. So here there is a negative relationship between the safety stock cost and the stock out cost, and the company should calculate each of them and to find this relationship, and at the end to take the final decision to choose the option which has the cheapest inventory policy, which refers to 10 units is the better option. Okay. Based on this page and based on this explanation for this type of problem, I will stop and I will complete the third part of this chapter in the next lecture, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.